Part of the motivation for this research is to better understand how wildfires spread. In some situations, wildfires spread from non-steady flame behavior that heats the fuel and contributes to flame spread. However, if you're going to try to study that, it's kind of hard to do that in a small-scale laboratory test. But actually, if we go up into space, in the space station, we don't have the effect of gravity or buoyancy, and we can control the flame by controlling the airflow, and we can recreate similar non-steady flame behaviors with that airflow, and that'll help us better understand the role of those non-steady flame behaviors on flame spread. So the experiment on the ISS is going to involve a fuel sample that's about this big, and then that's going to be inside of a wind tunnel that's about this big. It all happens in a sealed vessel that's going to be probably about this big. The main data that we're going to get back from the International Space Station experiments will be video footage of the experiment and then a couple other sensors, including things like radiant heat flux and temperatures and flow velocities. And what we'll do is from that video footage, extract geometric features from the flames to track one, how fast they're spreading, but also two, the shape of the flame and how that impacts how well it's heating the fuel ahead of it as it spreads. The insight from this research could help inform flame spread modeling both at the small scale but also for larger scale wildfire modeling. Improved fire modeling capabilities are important because it helps us understand how to respond to a fire but also how to prepare against a hypothetical fire that may happen in the future.